I am Radek, you know me online as RH3D, and this is the E3NG or Ender3NG. And if you don't know already, I finally released files for the first non-beta, the v1.2, and there is a lot about the project, so keep watching so you don't miss anything important. In this video, I will talk a little bit more about the project, what it is and how you got here. You will find out about the current release, what does it include right now, but also what is currently missing and will be available in the future. And of course, I will share some future plans and some exciting news for you if you are thinking about building one. So what is the E3NG or Ender3NG? As the name says, it is a project to take your Ender3, Pro, V2 and other similar 3D printers, take it apart and rebuild it into a much more capable, reliable or even enclosed coreXY machine. And one of the main goals of the project was to reuse as many parts as possible, so you will still keep most of the frame parts, the bed carriage and the heated bed plate, the PSU, stepper motors, wiring, you can reuse the motherboard and some other parts. And the project is also aiming to build a really feature-rich, compatible and capable machine. As you can see, these two printers are quite a lot different, even though they are coming from the same E3NG, same project. And that is because the project itself is quite a lot configurable. To get to this point, it started with the beta version that was released more than a year ago. And from that time, the Discord community and the user base was growing, people were into the project, building the E3NG, and from the beginning I was really listening to all the feedback, issues, preferences and ideas, and as a result, after basically working on it for a year, we now have a project that can be configured to really fit your preferences, needs and your budget. Apart from that, I have been hard working on optimizing the bill of material. I reduced the hardware size variety by about 40%, so it is also much easier to source and build. I have revisited literally all the printed parts to make it better. And there are so many quality of life changes and overall upgrades, like the new belt tensioning, new tool head, the separate flexi joints to reduce the Z wobble, better AB stepper cooling. There are three options to build the frame. You can install the auxiliary fans, three rods for the Z axis, new enclosure, and there is just so much more. That was about the printer for now. But I plan to do another video where I will describe most of the features and options in more detail. And if you would like to see it and even have some ideas, you can leave a comment below and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the video. And now, what is coming in the current release? As the base of the project, there is a website now, rh3d.xyz. where you will always find all the necessary and up-to-date informations, links and basically everything you need for the project. The STL files are again hosted on printables, just because it is simple. You can preview the files, post comments, rate the project and upload or access remixes or mods. Again, link for the printables is on the website. Of course, you will also need a bill of material. But as I said previously, the project is quite a lot configurable. So we don't have a simple bill of material as usual, but instead we have a so-called configurator, which is a downloadable spreadsheet, but it has more things inside. First list is the configurator. There you will choose your preferred options for the build, and based on that, it automatically calculates and shows the accurate bill of material on the second list. It will also show you the correct parts you need to print, including the quantity, because there is around 240 STL files, but in the end you might need only half of these. As a bonus, on the configurator list, you will also see the calculated amount of filament you will need and the estimated price of the bomb. And there is also a list of verified kits if you don't want to source all the parts yourself. And by verified, I mean that the kits were made in some kind of cooperation and that I know the quality of these parts, so I can be sure that it is safe to buy them and I can recommend it. Because in the past there were some kits that were not official and I read about them from people who bought them that they are not very good quality. So because of that, I can only recommend kits that will be listed in the official documentation. Of course, you will also need some build instructions. Unfortunately, these are not ready yet, but I will be working on them intensively right after this first release stage. And if you want to build a printer now, there is option to get a CAD assembly files, which are available through a tiny donation on my Ko-fi profile page. And anybody who made some donation in the past can of course download the files again, which have been updated to the new version. So now, another very important topic. What is coming next? What are the future plans of the project? And what are the exciting news I was talking about in the beginning of the video? Obviously, I will be working on build instructions. I have also raw footage from rebuilding this printer that's gonna be enclosed very soon and that I can use for a build video. I will be processing any feedback I get from you. I will be more active and try to bring some cool things to the Discord server. I would like to shoot more detailed videos, but also I have a ton of ideas for other improvements and I have a few interesting projects that I would really love to grow and of course publish. To be honest, this all depends on you as well. I have been working on this project for almost a year and a half and for the last 7 months I basically switched it for my full-time job. And to be fair with you, even though I love the project, I love the development, designing, testing and working on such technology, it is far from enough to feed my family or even pay the bills. So after the current release stage, I will need to focus on other things as well. Because I just can't put so many of my own resources into the project anymore without some change. And that's where you can have an effect on the project and the future of it. I will, of course, work on the things I mentioned previously, but the speed of these updates will depend. So if you would like to help supporting the project, the other possible things that may come in the future, and help me get more time for it, you can do so through some of the platforms I will link in the video description. You will also find them on the website and if you will decide to do so, I will greatly appreciate it and I will try to get the best out of it back to you, the users and the 3D printing community. So thank you. And what about the exciting news? There will be kits to build the printer. Funny enough, it is currently 3Fs. Fabrico, Fansor and Fushi Bearings. Fabrico will be putting it together by the end of this year. I am currently testing the Fansor kit and with Fushi bearings we have been putting together a great choice of bearings and linear shafts, so you will get some nice parts with proper tolerances and quality for your money. I also have some other interesting kits and upgrades in the preparation, so stay tuned to see what the future brings and keep watching the updates. Okay, so let's end this video here. Feel free to like it or not, comment, subscribe, watch some of my other content, join the Discord, and now, thank you for watching, have a great day and be safe. Bye!